7 o'clock. Frost and fire, Alaska's changing climate. Dr. Nancy Fresco will talk about some research on that and climate change. And then on Thursdays, if you don't take in the music, there's a wonderful film being shown. And we knew how to dance women in World War I, talking about how they broke gender barriers during World War I. So those are some other events. They're all at 7 o'clock in this venue, except for the concert down in the garden there. So without further ado, let me introduce tonight's speaker. He's talking about nutrition strategies for a healthy, long life. Dr. Wren received his medical degree from Tulane Medical School in 1978 and completed his cardiology fellowship at Brooke Army Medical Center in Fort San Houston in Texas. He's practiced in Alexandria, Louisiana, the Sentinel Heart Specialist in Louisiana. He's an alumnus of the Louisiana State University and served in the United States Army Medical for 9 years. He's board certified in internal medicine, general cardiology, interventional cardiology, a whole slew of things. He shares his years of experience and passion for patient-focused care at the Porter Heart Center at Fairbanks Memorial Hospital. Please welcome Dr.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. was amazing. I think Chris can kill it. Yeah, but so this parents are only going to be the only oxidation, but it was far better than Jesus' platelets from being sticky. In the later studies, we've seen evidence that the issue of faith and death and prayer faith leads to bloodstream lowering effects. That will also turn through the trials. And we know that the dose of the dose is extremely high dose, 3 to 5 grams, to get the excess of flow out of the pill, whereas the blood is flowing at about 10 to 3 milligrams. So we don't know that we're used to this paradox. So it's the case where it's just that if you rub the blood of this marathon on the counter, that you can just be fine and have a glass of wine.
And we saw the depth of that being
Thank you.
self-discipline is a doctrine of conscious and condition the risk of developing chronic diseases. If someone was not only vegetarian, generally vegetarian and vegan, but then they announced that they made that it allows for meat. If you don't have meat, less than once a month, meat more than eggs, less than once a month, you still have the same benefit as being vegan. As I was saying, I assume one of the problems is that the most important thing is to get in this diet. There are lots of diets with vegan and the miscellaneous ones with problems in the diet. If you have a diet and you say you're doing this, you can't always do this thing. You might only have to have a diet. The diet is being given to start by diet. What is this diet? If this was shown to reverse heart disease, and you look at carbs, they're 74% carbs, 18% calories from the protein, and about 7% of fats, a very low fat diet, whereas the opioid spectrum, like this diet, which has been shown to see the increased risk of heart disease, has only 5% of carbs, 35% of protein, and very high fat, which is 11% of fat, and 30% of fat. So the best is 40% in carbs, 30% in fat, 30% in protein. The very low fat diet is going to be the most effective scale to reduce risk and to reverse heart disease. So what we have done with the biggest diet to do is that the first characterized by Benton in the 1860s, the main popular of Atkins, and that is 2 weeks. 2 weeks of extreme carbohydrate restriction. Right. also found that if you use focus CMC, expanding on protein, So, Thank you. Thank you.